Hi!
Welcome to Beach Kids. We hope you have a great time.
Enjoy the lesson.
I'm David, and today we're going to read the story called A New Way to See. Of all the people who kept the rules, Saul was the best. I'm good at being good, he'd tell you. He was very proud and very good, but he wasn't very nice. Saul hated anyone who loved Jesus. He traveled around looking for them. He wanted to catch them and put them in prison. He wanted everyone to forget about Jesus. He didn't believe Jesus was the rescuer. He didn't believe Jesus was alive either. You see, Saul had never met Jesus. So one day, Jesus met Saul. Here's a picture of Saul being all smug and ugly. Saul was on his way to Damascus when suddenly a dazzling light flashed like lightning. It was brighter than the sun. It was too bright. Saul shielded his eyes and fell to the ground. And he heard a loud voice, and it was too loud. It gave Saul a headache. Saul, Saul, said the loud voice, why are you fighting me? Lord, Saul answered, who are you? I am Jesus, said the voice. When you hurt my friends, you're hurting me too. Saul's whole body trembled. Go to the city, Jesus said. I'll tell you what to do. And here's Saul. He had fallen off of his horse and he's praying. He got knocked off by the bright light and he was talking to Jesus. When Saul opened his eyes, he couldn't see. His helpers had to hold his hand and lead him like a little child. Saul was blind for 3 whole days. And yet it was as if he was seeing for the very first time. Meanwhile, there was a man called Ananias who loved Jesus. Jesus came to him in a dream, saying, go to Saul and pray for him, and I will make him see again. Ananias knew all about Saul and how he hated Jesus' followers. Lord, Saul has come to hurt us. But Jesus told Ananias, Saul is the one I've chosen to tell the world who I am. So Ananias went to Saul and said, Brother Saul, it was Jesus you met on the road. And Ananias prayed for Saul. Suddenly, Saul could see again. But he saw everything differently. He wasn't mean anymore. He even changed his name from Saul to Paul, which means small and humble, the very opposite of proud. And do you know what Ananias' name means? The Lord is full of grace. Now, grace is just another word for gift, which is funny because that's what Paul's message was all about from then on. And here's Paul being led by Ananias around. It's not about keeping rules, Paul told people. You just have to believe what Jesus has done and follow him. It's not about trying, it's about trusting. It's not about rules, it's about grace, God's free gift that cost him everything. What changed for Paul? What happened to him? He met Jesus. Paul got a new job. He called himself a servant and traveled everywhere telling people about Jesus. He got shipwrecked 3 times. He even went to prison a lot. But it was all because he was telling people about Jesus. God loves us, he wrote from prison. Nothing can ever, no, not ever, separate us from the never stopping, never giving up, unbreaking, always and forever love of God that he showed us in Jesus. And so it was that just as God had promised Abraham that dark night all those years before, the family of God's children grew and grew until one day they would come to number more than even all the stars in the sky. Look, here's Paul being thrown in prison and shipwrecked, and all the time he was okay because he trusted God. Even though before he had been working so hard and trying so hard, he wasn't happy. He didn't have peace because he didn't know God. He didn't really know Jesus. But when he trusted Jesus, even when he went to prison and even when he got shipwrecked and people were fighting against him, he had peace and happiness because he knew Jesus. And so you can have peace and happiness too when you trust Jesus. No matter what comes at you, you can trust him and that he's with you and that he'll protect you. So Jesus, we thank you that we can trust you. We thank you that you've set us free and that you love us. And so no matter what comes at us, nothing can ever separate us from your never stopping, never giving up, unbreakable love. We thank you, Jesus. Amen.